Yeah, that's right. Well, the results of those elections are going to be coming out of this warehouse tomorrow night. But some fear that the results of the elections will be illegitimate because we told you on Friday that some families got extra ballots in the mail. Receiving too many ballots in a mail-in election, that could have a significant impact on your property taxes. I asked the Bernalillo County Clerk how that could be possible.
They've moved away from that home to another state, another address, whatever. But they never took the time to change their voter registration.
Bernalillo County Clerk Linda Stover says it is up to you to change or update your voter registration. If you don't take it upon yourself to do that,
according to our records, they live at 123 Apple Street. Where they've moved to 123 Orange Street, we have no idea.
Stover met with New Mexico's Republican Party Chairman Steve Pierce today, who says he's concerned about illegitimacies in mail-in elections.
How do we know that it's actually you who voted on your ballot?
He said in a press conference, the clerk's office's hands are tied, and that needs to change.
I walked out feeling comfortable that they're doing everything that they can by law. They know they should do more, but by law, they cannot do more.
So, Pierce is calling on state lawmakers to make changes, improving the ways New Mexico verifies ballots that are mailed in. When I asked Stover if she thinks there are illegitimacies in the voting process,
there really isn't, because we've got like 150 people checking these ballots and looking at them and counting them.
Yeah, so if the clerk's office says if you get a ballot in the mail and it's addressed to another family member and you fill it out, you could be charged with a fourth degree felony. Live in Albuquerque tonight, Justin Matthews, KOAT, Action 7 News.
If the bond measure passes, it would raise property taxes by about 5%. That's about $12 more per month for a $220,000 home.